I didn't want to win. First game. Go.
Graduate from high school. But then my math teacher, Mr. Cumberbatch, told me I'd failed his class and would have to repeat the year. I was devastated because I had already made plans to go to college. So I started crying and begged him to show mercy and let me pass. But he said, no, and shook his head. In a last attempt, I gave him a big hug and said, please, Mr. Cumberbatch, isn't there anything I can do? He pushed me away and said, no.
Thank you.
turn all my grades into straight A's, then I will change my mind on the baby. Mr. Cumberbatch was desperate. He agreed to the deal and snuck into our school at night to change my grades on the principal's computer. But 2 days later, on my graduation day, things went wrong. When my principal handed over my report card, he took a quick look at it and said,
"There must have been a mistake."
I immediately knew my plan had failed, and the next day I got my real report card, and my grades were terrible. The only A I got was in Mr. Cumberbatch's math class. I knew it wasn't his fault, but I was so angry, I found out his address and went to his house. A woman opened the door, and she was pregnant too! I asked her if she was the wife of Mr. Cumberbatch, and she said yes. For a moment, I had doubts, but then I looked straight into her eyes and said, "Your husband got me pregnant, and he has no interest in taking responsibility for his existence." I hoped she would get angry at her husband, but instead, she got angry at me. Mrs. Cumberbatch's daughter on a USB stick, put it in an envelope mother took her out of my arms and screamed at me. You dirty little girl! All you do is destroy happy families! I responded, such a happy family. Why didn't your husband tell you he's paying another $20,000 a month in child support? And where is he? She responded, you better not come here again. We're going to your mom's time.
Thank you.
conversation seemed pointless. Leaving and quit. The train took me to another city. I left, I got off, and bought myself some food. I was mesmerized by everything I was seeing. People, buildings, the cars, and everything around. Morning came, I had to look for a place to stay. The money I had was not enough to keep me out of the streets. I asked people about an orphanage and went there. I found a nice young woman who asked me about who I was. I lied and told her that my parents left me alone and I had no one I could live with. I told her that my name was Jaya. She told me I could live there as long as I behaved well. But she has to inform the authorities that a new girl was listed in the orphanage. Life was bad there. We didn't have enough food. We only got used clothes and managed with the donations people gave us. But people there were nice. No one was worshipping me now or offering me gifts, but I had time to do whatever I want and be by myself. The orphanage was only for girls. After having our poor breakfast, we would go to school and then go back and help clean the orphanage. Sometimes we would go out with our caretakers for a short visit to the town. Life was simple, but after I turned 17 years old, I started to worry. In a year, they would ask me to move out because I would legally be able to get a job. Where would I go? I thought about it a lot. One day, when we were buying groceries, I saw my sister. She changed a lot since the last time I saw her, but I could still recognize her face easily. She was walking with a man and a child. I was furious. I'd been living in this miserable life while she was having a life of her own. Happy, married, with a child. I called her by name, and she was shocked to see me. She looked at her husband and mumbled some words. He took the young boy and left, so we were left alone. Our meeting was not nice. I was angry, and she was arrogant enough not to admit that she had done something wrong. I asked for my money back. She said she did not have it, but she'll give me some money and get me a job so I can manage. I started working as a secretary for a company. The company would send girls to work as maids in foreign countries. I always wondered why so many girls were interested in this kind of job. I mean, it was all about cleaning and home chores. When I heard about how much money they were making, I wanted to go too. Why wouldn't I? I have no family here. I applied for the job, and because my boss liked me so much, he managed to find me a good family within a month. I traveled with all my belongings, money, my passport, personal documents, and my clothes, all in one suitcase. And just like that, I was the maid of a wealthy family. I had my own room, I worked 5 days a week, and got 2 days for myself. They offered me food and even bought me clothes sometimes. So, the salary I got was all for me. I could do whatever I want with it. Things weren't getting better until one of the family's boys fell in love with me. He saw me as the most beautiful girl he had ever met. He wanted to marry me. His family, particularly his mom, was not excited for it. But after they saw how determined he was, they gave in. I was over the moon. This meant the end of my misery. I was no longer a maid, and I was about to have a family. We married and lived in a big house. It was all peachy and rosy in the beginning. He loved me and bought me everything I asked for and everything I needed. I got pregnant and I was ready to have a baby when my husband died in a terrible car accident. Life became gloomy again. What the hell was I supposed to do now? My son's grandfather assured me that he'll keep taking care of me and give me an allowance, but I wanted more. I didn't want to go back to the poor life I had. I needed to secure myself. So after I gave birth, I started my own business. I founded a cleaning company. I would bring girls and women from my own country to work at other people's houses. It was a good business. Soon I became rich and I could live comfortably again.
FBI, but I know I have to do something because my dad needs to be stopped. stopped. I should have realized that he was weird when I was a kid. My dad always told me stories about a cannibal tribe in the Brazilian Amazonas. He told those stories with so much detail as if he had experienced it himself.
Did
you
do
No. I'm just fascinated by dead bodies.
Stop ringing me, I'm in zone wars. What do you want?
You wanna do the zone wars?
Can you play zone wars with me first?
Okay.
Thank you.
Trash. Oh, bye, bro, bye, no.